Open up your doors and let the sun shine in. And while you're at it, let the whole gang in. Oogie, Gertie, and Rhea to brighten your day each weekday morning at 9 on Television 11. Buccaneers, come aboard, me hearties. It's 4:30 and time for all good seamen to come and join Pete the Pirate for a half hour of fun and entertainment. We'll be joined by Papa, Bugs Bunny, and Sly, Sneaky, Sylvester Cat. So, heave-ho, and away we go.
The Fair Wind lies at anchor a half league east of the Leeward Islands. Off the larboard beam, the Flying Fox is hove to under the guns of Pete the Pirate's ship. For Pete has captured the Flying Fox and rescued Betty Belmont from Bad Bill Bradley.
Ahoy, Buccaneers, and welcome aboard the Fair Wind for today. I tell ye, it took us about that long to take care of Bad Bill Bradley, eh? You remember how easily we overcame him without firing a shot. And let me tell you more about it. Let me get down here on the quarter deck, and I'll tell you just how we're going to save this Betty Belmont. Now, here's what had happened. Bad Bill Bradley kidnapped a lady named Betty Belmont, a girl, actually. She's the daughter of Lord and Lady Belmont, and they lived on the island of Antago. Well, as you know, he hove to yesterday under our guns, and we went ashore, or rather went aboard his ship. And I tell you, Buccaneers, he never made a whimper, did exactly as I saw it, told him. And we now have him in irons, and his entire crew. I have 10 men from my ship aboard his. Calico Jack is leading that skeleton crew, and I'm going to have Calico Jack take the Flying Fox back to Antago to return Betty Belmont to her parents. Then I'm going to have him go right back on to Pirate Islands and put the Flying Fox in the guard fleet that surrounds Pirate Islands. Aye. And I tell you, the next time I go back to Pirate Islands, I'll pick up Jack and the men I've sent back with him. Didn't take us long to take care of that black-hearted rogue, did it? I tell you, no. Now, because of just such things as this, we need as fine a crew as we can muster, you and I. So let's be having a look to see who sails with Pete the Pirate on today's crew. Hide on over the capstan, strike up a chanty. Here they are, pinned right here to the mast.
In Amsterdam there lived a maid, mark well what I do say. In Amsterdam there lived a maid, and she was mistress of her trade. I'll go no more a-roving with you, fair maid. A-roving, a-roving, since roving's been my ruin. I'll go no more a-roving with you, fair maid. Her eyes is like the stars so bright, mark well what I do say. Her eyes is like the stars so bright, her face is fair, her step is light. I'll go no more a-roving with you.
Tis as fine a lot of seafaring folk as we've had aboard in a while, eh? I tell you, they're a fine lot now. I told you the Flying Fox was bound for Pirate Islands. And Calico Jack should have that ship just about ready to sail. I want to get Betty Belmont back to her parents as quickly as I can. Tell you what, let's see if we can make Jack hear us. He's not very far away there. Ahoy, Jack!
Aye, Captain.
There you are. Pretty efficient fellow, Jack. Are you about ready to make sail?
The men are at the capstan, sir, and ready to make sail.
I tell you, he's a good man. If it weren't for a long time, I'd have him as first mate, I would. Have you enough men aboard to handle her?
Aye, Captain. These men will take her through anything she can sail through.
It wouldn't be a very big storm by the look of the size of her. Well, make haste, then. You've a long way to go. And I want you to get Betty Belmont back to her parents safely.
With luck, we'll have her ashore in Antago by midday tomorrow.
All right, Jack. Goodbye.
Goodbye, Captain. I'll see you back at Pirate Islands.
Aye, I'll be there.
All right, now, Lance.
I tell you, he's a good man, Buccaneers, and I'm glad that Neptune talked me into going after the Flying Fox and making him return that little girl. I tell you, he's a black-hearted rogue, he is, and I'm glad we got him all straightened out. Oh, I meant to tell you, I forgot all about telling you about this. Just haven't noticed that. This is chest. That's the only bit of booty that Black Bill had aboard his ship. And I thought he might as well be relieved of it, but I didn't get a key, and I've had a little bit of trouble opening it. Let me see if I've got a knife here somewhere that I can maybe work on this lock a little bit with. I'm sure this is full of treasure. Now, let me... let's pry it loose.
Pizza dummy!
Now, Neptune, I'm surprised at you. I'd like to know why you say a thing like that. Didn't I rescue Betty Belmont and send her back to her parents just like you asked? Wasn't that what you wanted me to do all along?
Yeah. I don't mean that. That's not why you're a dummy.
Well, then why am I a dummy? Not why am I a dummy. I mean, why are you calling me a dummy, huh?
Because you think there's treasure in that chest.
Well, why shouldn't there be treasure in this chest? It's a treasure. It looks like a treasure chest. It's heavy. Of course there's treasure in this chest. It's plenty
heavy. Yes, but how could Bad Bill Bradley get treasure? Him sailing that little ketch, what's not much bigger than a longboat. Why, anybody could tell that he didn't have enough booty aboard that ship to buy a square meal, let alone...
You belay your squawking. Now, yeah, I'm trying to work on this. You're bothering me. I'm trying to get this chest open here.
No use opening it. There's not going to be anything in it.
I told you to be quiet. Now, I don't want another single word out of you. Now, you're just bothering me, and I can't get this chest open the way I think you should.
Pizza dummy.
I heard you. And I'm telling you that I don't want any more. I don't want you to say any more. I've warned you for the last time. You're going to get in real trouble if you keep talking that way now.
All right. No need to get mad about it.
Yeah. I need something heavier than this knife here. There. That's a bigger knife, huh? Now, let me see here. I don't know what the best way to do it. If I just had the key, I wouldn't have any problems, but let me see if I can start working on this edge with this big knife.
Need trying to open that chest. It's...
Now, I tell you, I'm going to pull every one of your tail feathers out if you don't be quiet. I don't want any more out of you at all. Not another word.
All right. I'm just trying to help.
Trying to help, a fat lot of help you are. You haven't done me any good at all.
Why don't you shoot the lock with a pistol?
Why don't you keep your trap shut? Shoot the lock with a pistol. That's the silly. Well, because I never thought of it. That's a pretty good idea. Yeah.
Hold your ears.
All right. Everybody holding their ears? Let's see, I get this about this way, I guess. Now, let's see if we can knock that off there, huh? There. Now, with any luck at all, we'll have that.
There's nothing in the chest! There's nothing in the chest!
Well, now, you just be quiet. There is, too, something in the chest. The only reason that I looked a little disappointed was there wasn't quite as much in there as I thought there was going to be. But there's plenty in the chest. And you've just talked, and I don't want another single word out of you. Now, you just pay close attention to what I'm saying. An old book. An old piece of paper. Few coins. There aren't many coins, I'll show you. Not a handful in the whole. A lot of it. Hey, Neptune. Yeah, I probably made him mad. Well, that's too bad, but that's the way it has to be. If he's mad, he's just mad. I'm sorry. Let me gather these up. Here. I tell you, when it comes to finding booty, buccaneers, I'm probably the unluckiest pirate who ever sailed the seas. There you are, not enough in there to buy much more than a square meal for crew for a day. Well, that's all right. Yeah, that's not gonna do me any good. Yeah, what's this? How about this book, eh? It's in German. Well, see what I've got here. Hey, buccaneers. Tis a treasure chart of some sort or another. Yeah. I can't make it. Oh, wait, here's Martinique. By heaven, a treasure chart. Aye, this may be worth more than if that chest had been filled with gold, eh? By Jove, I don't know, though. Martinique. Yeah. Sunken treasure, eh?
Pete!
I told you not to talk to me. Now you be quiet. I don't know where he went. Hey, Neptune, where'd you go there a minute ago? Huh? Where? Oh, blast it all. It's all right now. You can talk now. It's all right. I give you permission to talk because I want to know where you went. Where'd you go?
Down to the orlop deck.
The orlop deck. What'd you get down there for? Nothing down there but powder and shot.
There's something else.
Something else? What? What else is down there?
Fred's cage.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about that for a minute. Yeah, let's see where we go here. Yeah, I don't know. It's a few days' sail from here. Well, buccaneers, I suppose we could try it. Yeah, I forgot all about Fred's cage down there, Neptune. I didn't think of that.
Pete?
What do you want now, huh?
Fred's getting out of his cage.
What? What did you say? Fred's... Oh, Fred's not getting out of his cage. He's always playing tricks like that on me, see? Always telling me something's happened when it isn't happening at all.
Pete, no, I'm not. He really is getting out.
Now you listen here. You're just doing altogether too much talking. I don't want you playing any more tricks on me. I know I've been a little harsh with you today. I know that. But I don't want you playing any more tricks on me. I know that Fred wouldn't get out of that cage, and I want you to just be quiet.
Well, I warned him.
Well, Neptune, I tell you, I've got a little friend of mine here, and I want you to keep your mouth shut there for a minute, will you? Huh, Stripe? This is Stripey Stripe, Buccaneers, and you know what he tells you about, don't you? You ready to tell him today, Stripe? Well, tell him. Oh, he's too shy again, and he wants me to tell you that when you see the red stripes, you know you're getting the best germ killer in any toothpaste. It kills almost all the bad breath and tooth decay germs. And what's more, Stripe looks and tastes so good that you just naturally want to brush better and more often, as the dentist says you should. Now, Stripey, you have a song about that, haven't you? Well, why don't you sing it? Are you going to dance or are you going to sing? Some days, he's a dancer. See, he doesn't really dance very well, but he thinks he can. Stripey, don't dance. Don't, please, don't dance.
Fun, feet by both fun, cleans like crazy, creep, cry, crazy, keeps your mouth as fresh as a daisy. Stripe, Stripe.
Tastes good, too.
Aye, Buccaneers, you run along, Stripe, huh? You remember what Stripey has to say about Stripe toothpaste, and the next time you go to the store, you look for the good-tasting red and white toothpaste in a carton that looks just like that. And it's called Stripe. I tell you, you'll find it mighty fine tasting. Now, what... Well, I tell you, Buccaneers, there are some pretty bad problems with treasure of this kind, you see. Because, first of all, sunken treasure... Now, this indicates treasure off Martinique. Sunken treasure is, well, it's hard to get to, you see, because it's all down under the water. It's not like having to dig in the dirt. It's down there under the water. That's probably the biggest problem with it. Then two Martiniques a few days sail from here. And also, you're not sure that the map is accurate. Now, Edward II, of whom I know, has his name on this map. Well, now, Ed II was a pretty good pirate. So he just might well have either learned of sunken treasure here or have dropped some treasure in the water there himself, accidentally, or perhaps he buried it there as the best place. Now, I tell you what...
Here comes, Rick!
I tell you what we'll do here, Buccaneers. We'll give this some further thought. I don't want to go rushing off, you see, in a big hurry to get some gold if it's going to be a mistake. So tell you what we'll do. We'll just take this chart down below in a little bit and compare this chart with the charts I have of the waters and see how the sun is.
Hey, Pete, you dummy! Look behind you!
Hey, what's going on? Fred, now! Now, Fred, please. Look, Fred, now stop that. Fred! Now, hang it all. See, Buccaneers, he's not chasing me. He likes me so much he wants to hug me, and he hugs so tight that I can't... Fred, now that's enough. I've taught you. I thought we'd gone all through this once before. I've explained to you you can't hug people. You don't understand. You don't remember. You've got a thick skull. That's what's the matter with you. You don't pay attention to what I say. I'm ashamed of you. That's what I am. I'm angry with you. I'm really angry with you. I tell you, I'm ashamed, and I don't want to have any more of this. There. That ought to hold him for a while.
Ah! Now you've done it! Now you've done it! You've scared him!
Oh. I guess I have scared him. You shouldn't ever lose your temper with an animal that way. I shouldn't have done that. If you'd have said something, I wouldn't have done that. Well. All right, I'll have to apologize to him. Fred, I'm sorry about that. I didn't mean to yell at you. Come on out here and be my friend again. I did. Come on. Oh, please, Fred. I didn't want to. Fred, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to yell at you. Hang it all. Look, I tell you what I'll do. I'll show you another way to make friends. Okay? All right. Come here. Now, see that hugging? That's why you have to run from him. He hugs you so tight. Fred, I tell you, the hugging, you see, is liable to crush a man's ribs. So what we'll do, yeah, right in there. Not yours, but mine. See, you're a good deal... good deal bigger than I am. Good deal stronger, too. Now, we're going to shake hands, Fred. You know where your hand is? There, he does. He remembers that, anyway. You remember your hands. Now, what you do when you meet somebody instead of coming up and trying to hug them, Fred... You just put your hand out like that, see, towards him? That's good. Now, I suppose you're just meeting me for the first time, Fred. I'll teach you how to shake hands. That won't hurt much, see? And just put your hand... That's right, see? And then the other person will... No, Fred. No, you point it towards me, see? I'm meeting you. That's right. Now you're getting the idea. All right, point it right there towards me. That's good. Now you see... Fred! No! Fred! Fred, let go of my hand! Fred! No, I'm not angry. I'm not angry, but it's just that I guess all the bones are all right there. He's so blasted strong, Buccaneers, that you got... Yeah, you squeezed too tight, but I think rather than show you... No, I tell you, let's try something else, Fred. We'll bow. No hugging. No hugging. I've got another idea. It's even better. Even better than handshaking. This idea is when you first meet someone that you like, you bow to them. Now, here's what that means. You bend right here in the middle, and you just go right over like that. You see? And that means, how do you do? Good day. I hope you're feeling well. You see? Just right over that way. All right? Now, you pretend like... Let me see you do it once. Oh, that's grand, Fred. That's grand. Now, you turn around here and face me. No, you're right here towards me. Just face me, right? No, Fred. Fred, that's right. Now, when I tell you, when I say hello to you, you're going to bow to me, see? And I'm going to bow to you. Okay, how can we get hurt this way? Are you ready? All right. Hello, Fred. I tell you, Buccaneers, I don't think I'm ever going to be able to teach that ape any manners. Oh, boy, does he have a hard head. Fred, I haven't got time to do this. You're my friend and all, but look, if I gave you a banana, would you go back down below? He loves bananas, Buccaneers. I tell you, look here. There you are. There you are, Fred. You go down there in your cage and peel that, and I'll be along in a little while, and we'll get those bars all straightened out that I'm sure you must have bent. All right, just right down there. That's a boy. Right down there. Yeah, with a banana. That's right. Atta boy, Fred. There you go. I tell you, it's all right to have an ape as a member of your crew. See, he's a good friend of mine, you know. Sail ho. Where are we?
Dead ahead,
eh? What are we doing sailing into here? Hey, hold on. We're at anchor. Somebody's sailing toward us. Well, I tell you, Buccaneers, the man who called was in the crow's nest, and he's quite a distance above the deck, so we can't see anything from here yet. I'll get a spyglass and have a look, but I tell you, before I do that, I want to tell you about something. I don't know whether you know about this or not, but I want you to pay very close attention. I'm going to show you what a certain toy soldier discovered, Buccaneers, when he was standing near a certain cuckoo clock. That's right. And here's a little hint. This is a chocks bottle. Right here, full of chocks, the fruit-flavored, chewy multiple vitamin tablets. Now, just one tablet daily supplies all the vitamins that Buccaneers normally need to take. And chocks are good for you, too, I can tell you that. I tell you, to get back to that toy soldier, you watch this, eh? You'll learn a bit about that fella, I can tell you that.
Listen, listen to the clock. Time for eating, time for chocks. In a bottle or a box, every morning take your chocks. Vitamins so good for you.
Fruit flavored, good to chew.
Tick tock, say the clock. Every morning take your chocks.
Chocks in a bottle or a box.
You learned something about that toy soldier, huh? You remember what he said. Try those chocks yourself. Good tasting, too. Let me get a spyglass here, Buccaneers, and see if I can't see now who's coming up on us from forward. Might be able to make something out here. No, it can't be. It can't be. It is. Buccaneers! It's Captain Awfulmean! Blast the luck. Captain Awfulmean, hang it all. Oh, Awfulmean coming up on me just when I thought everything was fine. Well, I've got to do something. I've got to think fast. Now, just calm down here and think of what I'm going to do. Captain Awfulmean coming up. He sneaked up on me here, so I'm not going to be able to battle. Not going to be able to run from him. Stand by the way, anchor! Helmsman, do you helm there? I tell you, Buccaneers, we're going to have to do some few things here pretty fast. Let's see. Get those guns run out of the lava. Eric! Long Tom, send Eric back! Eric, get below and get the lodestones. All right. Now, Buccaneers, pistol. I want to tell you about the lodestones and about Awfulmean. You know Awfulmean to be as fierce a pirate as ever sailed the seven seas, eh? You can say that. Well, the last time we battled with Captain Awfulmean, we took a lodestone, which is a stone you find in the ground that is a natural magnet. Now, magnets are big pieces of metal, or in this case, stone, that draw metal to them. You see, you've probably seen magnets. All right, now, I tell you, we take these lodestones and we rub the cannonballs with the lodestones, making the cannonballs magnetic. When Awfulmean fires his cannonballs, we fire a magnetic cannonball. It goes right up and finds Captain Awfulmean's cannonball and hits it. And with any luck at all, we never get a single shot in the whole ship. Eric, here.
Here, I'll take this one. You pass those out to Tom and to Mr. Black on the larboard side.
She draws down on this.
Hard to larboard. Now let me. That should do it. I'll roll that forward. And another. And another. All right. Stand by to load those guns. Load guns 9, 3, and 7 on the starboard scud. All right, now, Buccaneers, you listen very carefully. If you hear a cannon shot, you tell me to fire. Stand by your guns. Fire that gun, Mr. Black, when I give the order. You hear anything? I know I hear nothing. Not a thing. He'll fire, though. He's got his guns run out and he's bearing down on us. And he'll fire early. All right, stand by your gun. Fire! Now watch the sky, Buccaneers. Watch the sky and hope we intercept the cannonball. There they go. We got him! Keep firing. Every time you hear a shot, you fire. All right, fire again. Fire again. Move down there, you powder monkeys. Got another one. All right, stand by the broadside. Get those magnetized cannonballs to the starboard side. I hope we can stop every cannonball that comes toward us on this broadside, Buccaneers. Move down there, Mr. Black. Every man to his cannons. Hard to larboard at the helm. He's coming close enough for us. I need to touch him. All right, now.
Suppose when I walk down the street and a big...
Buccaneers, Pete the Pirate is high above the deck of the Fair Wind, looking out to sea. A few moments ago, he was battling Captain Offalmean, yet now he's looking calmly out over the ocean. Pete seems very pleased. He's climbing down. He seems to have been looking for something up there, and evidently he saw what he wanted to see. What can Pete the Pirate have been looking for that pleases him so much? Why, you can see him chuckling to himself as he moves down the shroud. What can have happened to Captain Offalmean? I hope Pete tells us very soon.
Look at him run! Look at him run, Buccaneers! I tell you, those magnetized cannonballs, they do the job every time they do. Let your eye get below here. I want to talk some more about that treasure hunt that we might go on. We don't have to worry about Captain Offalmean for a while. We might as well figure out whether or not we wanted to go, whether or not we want to look for treasure. You're game for treasure hunt, aren't you? You always have been before, eh? All right, I tell you. I think sunken treasure is the thing for us. You and I better get bound for Martinique. Anytime you have a battle, however small, you're just likely to lose your barracks.